Hello guys, this is AJ and welcome back to AJ Automation. So guys, from this video I am going to start a new series on protractor tool. Okay, so in this series we are going to learn how you can use protractor for end-to-end testing for Angular and AngularJS application. Okay, so I am going to cover from the basic thing what exactly the protractor is, and we will see how you can perform end-to-end testing using the protractor tool. Okay, so on my YouTube channel I have already uploaded I think more than 10 videos on the Selenium WebDriver. So how you can use Selenium WebDriver for automating the testing for the web applications. So if you want to learn, then you can go to my channel and there is a playlist. Okay, you can see those videos. Okay, so there is another tool, Protractor, which is widely used for the testing for specific application, and those are Angular and AngularJS. Okay, so we will see in detail the introduction and theoretical part behind this. Okay, so let's get started. Okay, so what is Protractor? So if you want to define it, so Protractor is an open source end-to-end testing framework for Angular and AngularJS applications. Okay, so here this end-to-end, what is end-to-end means, it will support starting from the login into the application. Okay, we will perform some action, let's say for example for a Flipkart kind of application, we will login into the app, then we will search the objects or search the elements according to our requirement, then we will add them into the cart, and then we will perform the checkout. So all these actions, okay, all these actions can be automated using the protractor. So that is what we call as an end-to-end. Okay, so it's a framework for Angular and AngularJS. So what is Angular and AngularJS? We will see in the next slide. So what exactly it is. So Protractor is nothing but a wrapper created on top of WebDriver.js. So, okay, so this WebDriver.js is the language binding provided by the Selenium guys, okay, for the JavaScript applications. Okay, it's based on the JavaScript. Okay, that's why it's known as a WebDriver.js. Okay, so using the Protractor, you can perform and you can automate the web browsers, and you can perform the same actions which can end user can perform on an application using the real browsers. Okay, so as Protractor supports Angular and AngularJS, so AngularJS is the front-end web framework developed by the Google in 2010. Okay, so that is a JavaScript based framework, and that is a Angular one. Okay, AngularJS. So when JavaScript means when we create a web application, okay, and when we have to add a dynamic content or dynamic elements into that web page, okay, you need to use JavaScript and CSS. Okay, so this is the AngularJS is the front end technology which support this dynamic web page creation, and that was developed by the Google in 2010. Okay, and after that, in just 4 years back, they released another version which is Angular, and it is also developed by the Google, and it is based on the TypeScript. Okay, so we will in this session, in the series, we are going to learn what exactly this some basic about the JavaScript and then TypeScript, how you can use, and for creating the automating test cases for the protractor, we are going to use the JavaScript. Okay, and this Angular is known as Angular 2. So from 2016 it has the very famous front-end technology to create the dynamic web pages, and most of the companies they are creating their web applications using the the same. Okay, so this is only for your information, which languages are used for front-end development and which languages used for the back-end. So the HTML, when you create the web pages using the HTML, that will be the static one. So if you want to add a dynamic content, we use JavaScript and CSS, and for backend we have Java, Python, PHP along with the Ruby and .NET. Okay, so if you want to learn more about this front end and back end, you know, technologies, you can, you know, I will suggest to go on Google and learn it. I'm not going to cover that in detail at this point. It is not necessary. Okay, so let's go and see where exactly our protector is there. So as I already told, like protector is just a wrapper on top of WebDriver.js. Okay, so all the functionalities supported by this WebDriver.js are supported by the protector, along with some additional functionalities are there. Okay, for testing the Angular and AngularJS applications. Okay, so whatever script we write in our laptop, that is present in our one of the local machine. Okay, so to run that script, okay, which is written in JavaScript, we need a runtime environment, right? For you know, for example, for for Java, we use JDK, like Java Development Kit or Java Runtime Environment, for running our Java programs. So similarly, for JavaScript, okay, Node.js applications, we need a Node.js installed in our machine. Okay, so using the Node.js and protector commands, we will be able to run the script. So Jasmine is nothing but the BDD framework. So using that, similar to the test ng, we will create different test cases. Okay. So how communication is happening? Okay. So your script, the protector script written in JavaScript, is present in your laptop. So how it will communicate with the actual application which is running on, you know, the actual browser. Okay, so it will communicate through this Selenium server. It is the Selenium standalone server. Okay, so and we already know that during the Selenium web driver, we need to use this browser drivers. Okay, without which we cannot directly communicate with the actual browsers. So we need to, you know, install Chrome driver, Gecko driver, and IE driver. These are already available on the net. So we need to download the driver executable in your local machine, and then you will be able to communicate with the actual browsers. Okay, so this communication is happening through the JSON wire protocol. Okay, the whatever commands, the protector commands and Jasmine framework we are going to use. Okay, so when you run that protector script through the, you know, on the Node.js platform, so it will, you know, first communicate to the Selenium server. It will send the requests. That request is sent to the browser drivers using the JSON wire protocol, and then it will perform the necessary action. Okay, what we are performing through the script on the actual browsers. Okay, so let us go and see some advantages of the protector. So protector will support both Angular and non-Angular JS applications. So as far as Selenium WebDriver is concerned, you cannot use it for the Angular application. The reason is because in Angular application we will have some Angular related web elements, and that web elements will have some ng binding or ng elements. Okay, it cannot be identified using the our locating different locating locators available in the Selenium WebDriver. For example, XPath, CSS, ID. So these are already, you know, it's supported by the protector also, but for identify the Angular elements, there is some Angular specific locators are required, and that are supported by the protector. So in coming video, we will see how to use that. Okay, so this is another advantage of the protectors. Its syntax to write the test cases is very simple as compared to the Selenium, and you can run your test case on the multiple browsers at once using the Selenium grid. Okay. Also you won't require to add any, you know, implicit weight or explicit weight. Okay, for Selenium WebDriver, we need to, you know, deal with the synchronization. There is I have created a three big session on this synchronization, how to achieve in WebDriver.js. So in Selenium WebDriver, sorry. So that kind of thing we don't have to worry about in the protector. So that was a big headache, how you can perform and how, you know, this is a dynamic loading of the web elements. So protector will handle this internally itself. Okay, we don't have to worry about it. So that is the major advantage of protector. And similar to the Selenium, it supports multiple browser, Firefox, Chrome, Safari and Internet Explorer. Okay, so I think this is only the theoretical part, the introduction part for the protector. So in next lecture we are going to see the actual installation, the things we require to run our protector script, the configuration we are going to see, and the prerequisite, what are the different application we need to install in our laptop and the machine. And then we will write our first test case and we will run that, and then we will see how we can automate the sample Angular application. Okay, so that's it for this session. Don't forget to subscribe, like and share this video with your friends. This coming video I'm going to this is going to be a big series on protector, so I'm going to cover from the basic thing to the how you can perform the end-to-end testing using the protector. Okay, we will also see the testing framework using the page object model, page object model too, and that framework we will use for performing end-to-end testing on Angular application. So let's see, I'm going to cover and I'm going to upload the videos as soon as possible. So just subscribe, like and share this video with your friends who want to learn the automation testing. So you can learn at free of cost both the Selenium WebDriver and this protector series. Also in coming days I'm going to upload the series for WebDriver IO as well. So along with the protector, WebDriver IO is there, which supports the Angular and AngularJS application automation testing, and that is more famous nowadays than the protector. But once you learn this protector, then that will be easy to learn the WebDriver IO. Okay, so this going to be a good learning in future. So that's it for this lecture. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next lecture.